Okay, now in today's lecture, we will study multiple choice questions on network theorems. This is actually first lecture on network theorems. In network theorems, we have these many topics: Kirchhoff's law, voltage and current divider circuit, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, superposition theorem and maximum power transfer theorem. In this lecture, we'll discuss multiple choice questions on these two topics and some simple electrical circuits. And in next lecture, we'll discuss MCQs on these topics. So first, we'll study simple basic of network theorems. So you have already studied network theorem, so we'll directly go to multiple choice questions. Now here, first multiple choice question. If 1 ampere current flow in a circuit, the number of electrons flowing through this circuit in 1 second is A 6.25 into 10 raised to 18, B 1.6 into 10 raised to 19, C 6.25 into 10 raised to 14, D 1 into 10 raised to 5. Now, if we take any circuit, so suppose this is simple circuit, this is battery of EMF E, these are resistances in the circuit. I have taken simple circuit R1, R2, and what happens here? Current flows through the circuit. In general, we know current is dQ by dt. dQ by dt means dQ, that is amount of charge flowing in time dt. So we can approximate this as Q upon t. Q is charge flowing in time t. Now, here, charge is always multiple of electronic charge, that is E, 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. So charge is always multiple of electronic charge. So electronic charge is basic charge. So if we take 1 coulomb charge, means there are number of electrons that constitute 1 coulomb charge. So here current is 1 ampere. So it gives you 1 coulomb per second. Now if Q is charge, it is multiple of electronic charge. Now Q is how much? 1 coulomb. So it is equal to N into electronic charge. So what is N? N is equal to 1 upon E. So here it is 1 upon 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. So find out this. 1 upon 1.6 into 10 raised to 90. So 1 upon 1.6, you will get 0.625 into 10 raised to 90. So this is how much? 6.25 into 10 raised to 18. So these many electrons will flow through the circuit when current is 1 ampere. And these many electrons flow in 1 second. So out of four alternatives, this first one is correct. This first one is correct. Now, a passive network is one which contains. So see, this is something network. This is network circuit. So we have active network and passive network. Passive network, that is network of electrical components in which there is no source of EMF. No source of EMF. So here a passive network is one which contains only variable resistance? No. Some source of EMF and resistance in it? No. Two sources of EMF in it? No. So no source of EMF in it. That network is called passive network. If any circuit or network has source of EMF, then that network is active network. Current will flow through that and so on. Now a linear circuit is one whose parameter changes with change in voltage, changes with both voltage and current, do not change with voltage and current. So here linear circuit. Now components may be parameters may be like resistance, capacitance, inductor and so on. So the linear circuit is the circuit in which parameters do not change with voltage and current. If we see any resistance, suppose, and if we apply potential difference across this variable, so current will be variable, but value of resistance will remain the same. So do not change with voltage and current, that is called linear circuit. Now next one, what is the equivalent resistance between A and B? Circuit is given. A greater than 2R, B 2R, less than R, 3R by 2. So what will be the resistance between A and B? Any idea? Hello. So here A is point, this is resistance R, and now for this combination, this is parallel combination, we can have equivalent resistance. Let us call this as RB. Now what is RB? So for parallel combination, 1 upon RB is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. But R1 and R2, this is R1, this is R2, they are same. So you'll get 1 upon R plus 1 upon R. So it is what? 2 by R. So it is 1 upon RP. So what is RP? RP is R by 2. And now R and RP, they are in series. So resultant series resistance, it is R plus RP. So we get here R plus R by 2. So if we find this, we will get 3R by 2. This is resistance between A and B. So 3R by 2. So here last one is correct. Last one is correct. Now we'll go to next one. A simple series circuit is given in figure. Across which resistance the potential difference will be more? So here simple circuit is given, this is series circuit. So we have here resistance R1, suppose. Here this is resistance R1, this is R2, and this third one is R3. Now they are in series across battery of 12 volt. So let us call that battery of EMF E. We have to find across which resistance potential difference will be more. Now we know V is equal to IR. This is Ohm's law. When I is current flowing through the circuit, through the resistance R, potential difference across the resistance is I into R. So first we must know what is current through this. So if we start from positive terminal of battery and go towards negative terminal. We have three resistances in path, they are in series. So current is EMF upon total resistance. And total resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3 because they are in series. So here we have 12 volt divided by now 1 plus 2 plus 3. 1 plus 2 plus 3. So we will get 12 by 6. So it is 2 ampere. So 2 ampere current flows through the circuit. And now that current flows through R1, R2, R3 because they are in series. When resistances are in series, same current will flow through them. Now, if we take V1, that is IR1, V2, that is IR2, V3, that is IR3. Now, find here 2 into 1, now 2 into 2, and 2 into 3. So, you will get here 2 volt, here it is 4 volt, and here it is 6 volt. So, we will get this. So, we will observe that across this R3, you will get more potential difference, that is 6 volt. So, here we have 3 kilo ohm. Actually, it is kilo ohm. So, here kilo ohm. So, here into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. So, it is 2 milliampere actually. 2 milliampere. All are in K. So, here 2 kilo ohm into 2 milliampere, it will give you 2 volt. 1 kilo ohm into 2 milliampere. 2 kilo ohm into 2 milliampere. 3 kilo ohm into 2 milliampere. That one will give you 6 volt. So 3K. Now next one. A network consists of linear resistors and ideal voltage source as seen in figure. In question 5, is this one, same one. If the value of each resistor is doubled, then voltage across each resistor is halved, doubled, increased 4 times, not changed. So, what happens here? In place of 1 kilo ohm, we have taken here 2 kilo ohm. Here, 4 kilo ohm. And here 6 kilo ohm. We have to find whether potential difference is changing or not. So what happens in this case? Now current in this case, it is 12 volt divided by 6 plus 4 plus 2. So that is 12 kilo ohm. 12 kilo ohm means 12 into 10 raised to 3 ohm. So, you will get what? 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. So, this is current. So, what happens? Resistances, we have increased values of resistances. So, current is decreased. So, what happens to the potential difference? So, if we take V1, now resistance is 2 kilo ohm, 2 into 10 raised to 3 multiplied by 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. So, this is 2 volt. V2. Now resistance is what? 4 into 10 raised to 3 into current is 1 into 10 raised to minus 3. So you will get what? 4 volt. So V3 is equal to. Now resistance is 6 kilo ohm. That is 6 into 10 raised to 3 ohm into 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. So this gives you 6 volt. So, see here, there is no change in potential difference, though the values are increased. So, here, out of these 4 alternatives, this last one is correct. This last one is correct, not changed. Now, see carefully, 4 circuits are given. In which of the following circuits, the current will be more. Current will be more. So, suppose we take any equivalent circuit having battery of EMF E and equivalent resistance R, I will take RE suppose, equivalent resistance. Then what is current through this? Current through this is I is equal to E upon RE. E upon RE. Now see here, this first one, we have resistance R and here battery of EMF E. So in A, here current will be, I can take I1. I1 is equal to E upon R1. Now we will go to B. Now here these two resistances are in series. So we can have single equivalent resistance. They are in series. So R plus R. So we will get 2R. In place of this, we have equivalent resistance 2R. So B is equal to what? I2. So I2 will flow here. So it is E upon 2R. Here E upon R. E upon 2R. Now we'll go to third one. Now see here. If we see here, two resistances are in parallel. So we can take here for C, 1 upon RP is equal to 1 upon R plus 1 upon R. So here 2 by R. So RP is equal to R by 2. So what happens here in circuit, we get resistance RP. And what is current? I can take that current as I3. I3 is equal to E upon RP. The equivalent resistance is RP. So I3 will be equal to E upon R by 2. R by 2. So I can write here 2E upon R. Now we will go to last one. D. Now three resistances are in parallel. So I can write 1 upon RP is equal to 1 upon R plus 1 upon R plus 1 upon R. So we'll get this as 3 by R. So what is RP? RP is equal to R by 3. So it's same like this. So what is current? I4 is equal to equivalent resistance is RP across E. So E upon RP. So we'll get what? E upon R by 3. So I can write 3E by R. So in which one current will be more? D. So it is D. It is D. Now next one. What is the potential difference between A and B? Now we know, suppose current is flowing from point A to point B, maybe through resistance, we have V is equal to IR. So we will get potential difference across resistance when current is flowing through that resistance. Now if we see here, if we start from battery, so if we go along this path, we come at A. A to B, there is open. So this circuit is open. And then we go from B to V. Since circuit is open, no current will flow through resistance. So here, no current flows through 3 ohm resistance. So potential difference across this is 0. Potential difference across this is 0. So what happens? This point and this point. So here this point, positive terminal of the battery and A, they are at the same potential. This point and this point, they are at the same potential. Because here V is equal to 0, here V is equal to 0. So what is potential difference between A and B? it is 10 volt, because point A is at the potential of positive terminal of battery, potential B is having potential equal to potential at the negative terminal of battery, so potential difference is 10 volt. So it is 10 volt. Nodal analysis is based on, nodal means what? Suppose we have some circuit like this. Now this one is called node. Suppose we take point A, this point A is called node. So resistance R1, R2, R3, R4. So that point A is called node. And we analyze that current at point A and so on using Kirchhoff's current law. So nodal analysis based on Kirchhoff's current law. Now next one, if two resistances of 20 ohm and 30 ohm are connected in parallel to a battery of EMF 24 volts, then the current flowing through 20 ohm each, 2 ampere, 0.8 ampere, 1.2 ampere, 0.5 ampere. So here what is given? So we have here battery of EMF E and that is 24 volts. Then two resistances, 20 ohm and 30 ohm are connected in parallel. So here we have first resistance and then we have second resistance R1, R2, this is 20 ohm and this is 30 ohm and they are across EMF. So what happens here? Current will, now current will flow through the circuit due to combination of these two resistances. Now they are in parallel, so we can have here equivalent circuit. Here it is RP and here E. Now what is RP? So R1 and R2 are in parallel, so 1 upon Rp will be equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. This gives you Rp is equal to R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. So Rp is 20 into 30 divided by 20 plus 30. So it is 600 divided by 50. So we'll get here 12. So 12 ohm. So what is current? Current is I is equal to E upon Rp, that is 24 volt divided by 12 ohm. So it is 2 ampere current. That is total current flowing through the circuit. Now when that current comes here, it has two paths. So I1, I2. So this point A I will take, that is node, and we get here I is equal to what? I1 plus I2. Now see here, R1 is across battery, R2 is across battery. So what happens here, if we take E, it is I1 R1 and E is also equal to I2R. So in this way you can find I1 for parallel circuits. It comes out to be I into R2 upon R1 plus R. Simply use this here. So I1 is equal to R into this ratio. So R1 plus R2, that is addition of two resistances in parallel. So if we want to find current through first resistance, use here second resistance. Similarly, I2 will be equal to total resistance multiplied by R1 upon R1 plus R2. Okay. So here we have to find through 20 ohm. So that is I1. So I is what? Total current 2. What is R2? It is 30 divided by R1 plus R2, that is 50. So it is 2 into 3 by 5. So it is 6 by 5. So if we take 6 by 5, it comes out to be 1.2 ampere. So here, this third one is correct. Third one is correct. Is it clear to you? Okay. If you have any problem, you can ask me. Now we'll go to next one. Kirchhoff's current law is based on the charge can be accumulated at the node. Charge cannot be accumulated at the node. Energy stored at the node. Depending on the circuit, charge can be accumulated at the circuit. Now see here, if we take any circuit, so here we apply Kirchhoff's law. So here this is resistance, suppose R1, R2, this is node, then R3, R4, R5, and suppose we have here current that is incoming, so I1, I2 towards node or junction, and here I3, I4, I5, that are outgoing currents. And according to Kirchhoff's current law, at junction, algebraic sum of all currents is zero. So this gives you total incoming current will be equal to total outgoing current. What is total incoming current? That is I1 plus I2. That is total incoming current. And what is total outgoing current? I3 plus I4 plus I5. So here this is total incoming current is equal to total outgoing current. This is Kirchhoff's current law. What is current? Current is rate of flow of charge. So means when current is flowing towards point A, means charges are flowing towards point A in time, with time. So suppose Q, it is amount of charge flowing in 1 second towards point A, that gives you total current I1 plus I2. Now if Q dash, it is total charge flowing away from point A. So Q towards point A, Q away from point A in 1 second. So both will constitute current. But since total incoming current is equal to total outgoing current, so total incoming charge will be equal to total outgoing charge. Now see here, branches may be more. Outgoing branches may be more, incoming branches may be less, or incoming branches may be more, outgoing branches may be less from that node. But total incoming current is equal to total outgoing current. So whatever charge flows towards point A, that goes out from point A. So at point A, there is no accumulation of charge. There is no accumulation of charge. So at point A, there will be some charge because it is point of conducting material. Suppose Q is charge present at point A at time t. With time t, that charge will remain constant. Whatever total charge comes to the point A, that much charge will go out. So at point A, there is no accumulation of charge. So here, charge cannot be accumulated at the node. So Kirchhoff's law is based, Kirchhoff's current law is based on this. That's why this Kirchhoff's current law is also called law of conservation of charge. Means in the circuit, charge is neither created nor destroyed, only it flows. Only it flows. Next one. When two terminals of the circuit is open, then the resistance between two terminals is. So just we have seen open circuit. E, R1, R2, point A, point B. So this is open. And according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. So what is R? R is equal to V upon I. But what is I? I is zero because circuit is open. So no current flows from A to B. So I can say R is V upon zero. So R is infinite. So this has infinite resistance. So this one is correct. Now next one, a certain circuit has three incoming currents having values 3 ampere, 9 ampere and 2 ampere and two outgoing currents passing through two parallel resistors having equal values of resistors. The outgoing current flowing through first parallel resistor will be. So what is meaning of this? Certain circuit has three incoming currents. Means here you can take this is first branch, this is second branch, and this is third branch. So I can take this point A. And now here this is first branch, second branch, third branch. Resistance may be R1, R2, R3 and three currents are coming. And what is that? 5 ampere, 9 ampere, 2 ampere. And current is outgoing through two parallel resistances. So you can take like this. Parallel resistance. So current is out. Now here parallel resistance I can take R4 and R4 because they are same. So what happens here? Total incoming current I can take II incoming current. That is 5 ampere plus 9 ampere plus 2 ampere. So this gives you 16 ampere. That is total out incoming current. Outgoing current will be also 16 ampere. IO, outgoing current. But it will go through two branches. Since two resistances are the same, it is equally divided. So if we take this first one, 8 ampere will flow. And second one 8 ampere will flow. If one of them, suppose we have two resistances in parallel, when resistance is more, less current will flow. When resistance is less, more current will flow in the parallel circuit. But here two resistances are same, so same current will flow. So total outgoing current will be equally divided. So here 8 ampere. Now Kirchhoff's voltage law is law of conservation of. What is Kirchhoff's voltage law? Is equal to applied EMF. So if we take closed network, suppose we have battery, this is source of EMF, and suppose we have three resistances R1, R2, R3, and current will flow plus minus E. So here we will get potential difference V1, V2, V3. And we know V1 is I into R1, V2 is I into R2, V3 is I into R3. So V1 plus V2 plus V3 will be equal to E. This is Kirchhoff's voltage law. Sum of potential differences across all the components in closed circuit will be equal to applied EMF. So I can take here, we know this is a summation IR is equal to I into R1 plus I into R2 plus I into R3, or you can write summation IR minus E is equal to 0. Now potential difference or EMF, it is measure of energy, and that does not change. That does not change. That's why Kirchhoff's voltage law is law of conservation of energy, while Kirchhoff's current law is law of conservation of charge. Law of conservation of charge. Now next one. Now it is simple one. A network consisting of DC battery of EMF 12 volts and internal resistance of 2 ohm. Then the power transferred to a load resistance 4 ohm will be 12 watt, 3 watt, 16 watt, 6 watt. Now what is given in here in this problem? Here we have battery of EMF suppose E, and it has internal resistance R, and across this load resistance capital R is connected. So what happens here? When we connect load resistance across the source, current starts flowing, and when current starts flowing through the circuit, it flows through resistance R, resistance capital R, that is load resistance, as well as through internal resistance of the battery. Now we know resistance opposes the current. Current is rate of flow of charge. So charges will try to flow through the resistance, and that is due to what? Power delivered by the source of EMF to the resistance, or power transfer. Now if I is current, what is power loss across the resistance? It is I square R. That is power loss. So first we must know what is I. So what happens here? I is equal to E upon total resistance. What is total resistance? It is closed circuit. What is total resistance? It is R plus small r, load resistance plus internal resistance. So when battery has internal resistance, whatever current flows through the circuit, it depends on internal resistance also. Now here is 12 volt. Internal resistance is 2 ohm. Load resistance is 4 ohm. So we'll get what? 12 divided by 4 ohm plus 2 ohm. That is 12 by 6. So it is 2 ampere. So this much current is flowing through the circuit and through the resistance R, capital R. So P is equal to I square R. So I is 2. So 2 square, that is 4, into what? R is 4. So we will get 16, and power it is in watt. So 16 watt. So out of these 4, this third one is correct, that is C, 16 watt is correct. Now we'll go to next one. In the following circuit, comma ISC, that is short circuit current, is 1 ampere, 0.91 ampere, 0 ampere, 1.2 ampere. So this circuit is given. So here we have battery of EMF. I can call this as resistance R1, resistance R2, resistance R3, and from point A to point B we have short, and we have to find current through short. Now current is flowing from A to B, means simply wire is connected here. Between A and B, wire is connected, that is called short. So what happens? From battery we will get total current I. At point C, I is divided into two parts, I2, I3. I will take incoming current as I1, and whatever I3, it will flow through this short. So ISC will be equal to I3. Now what is equivalent resistance of this circuit? So see here, if we take, this is battery, I am drawing equivalent circuit. So at point C, I have two resistances, R2, so this is point C, and R3. And it goes to battery. So what happens? R2 and R3, they are in parallel. They are in parallel. So we have to find their, so what is equivalent circuit? This is like this. R1 and RP. Now this RP, RP is parallel combination of this. Now RP is equal to how much now? RP will be equal to R2 into R3 upon R2 plus R3. So R2 is 4, R3 is 6, and here it is 6 plus 4. So it is 24 divided by 10. That is 2.4 ohm. So here now 2 ohm and 2.4 ohm. What is current I1 through the circuit? So I1 will be equal to E upon R1 plus R. So it is 10 volt divided by 2 plus 2.4. So it is 10 divided by 4.4 ampere. This is I1. So now I1, it is 2.4 sorry 10 upon 4.4 ampere. So that one will come here, and that is divided into two parts, I2. So I1 is total incoming current. So I have to find I3. I3 is equal to total incoming current. I3 is equal to I1 into, we have seen already, we have to find through R3. So we have to use here R2. R2 upon R2 plus R3. That gives you, so when we want to find current through this branch, we have to use this resistance here and divided by addition of two resistances. So it is 10 upon 4.4 into R2 is 4 divided by 10. So here 10 will cancel, 4 upon 4.4. What is 4 upon 4.4? It is 0.909 something. So it is 0.91 ampere. So this one approximately 0.91 ampere. Is it clear to you? Okay. Now we will go to next one. What will be the potential difference between points A and B of a branch of some circuit when current through it is 0.1 ampere? Means we have network. In that network, means you can have network like this. So here battery of EMF, resistance, then resistance, battery. This is one branch. Then you can have second branch and so on. Then you can have third branch. This is resistance, like this. So this is some network, and we can take this part of network. So this point is A, this point is B. So here that is given. Here that is given. So from point A to point B, current will flow. So there will be some potential difference between point A and B. That we have to find. So how can we find? So when we solve any network, we use Kirchhoff's law, Kirchhoff's current law and Kirchhoff's voltage law. So when we want to use Kirchhoff's voltage law, we consider some points. What are that points? So when we go through any branch of the circuit, when we want to find potential difference, that potential difference is either positive or negative. So when we go from point A to point B through the branch, and suppose this is direction of current, okay, and you can have any component here. So I can take component. Now that component may be resistance, maybe capacitor, maybe inductor, maybe here. So when we go from point A to point B and current is suppose from A to B, if we go across this component, when there is rise in potential, so when there is rise in potential, is taken as positive. And fall in potential as negative. So what happens here? If at this point we have potential V1 and at this point potential is V2 when we go from A to B. If V2 is greater than V1, there is rise in potential. Take difference is positive. But when V2 is less than V1, there is fall in potential. So take difference negative. Means here potential difference negative. So here see, we have given here branch. So here branch is given. Branch is given. So it is part of circuit. So A to B. Now here direction of current is given. Current is flowing from A to B. So first you will have resistance R1. Here you will have resistance R1. Now see here, when current flows through the resistance, it always flow from higher potential to lower potential. So here I can take here V1. So what is V1? V1 is I into R1. But we have to take this as negative because current flows from higher potential to lower potential across resistance. Then here battery. So what happens here? Minus I R1 we have to take. Then we will come here. Now we have to go from this point to this point. So we are going through the battery. Now this is positive terminal of battery. This is negative terminal of battery. So when we go from positive terminal of the battery to negative terminal of battery, there is fall in potential. So we have to take that potential as negative. So we have to take that as minus E1. Then we are here. We have to go from across resistance R2. Again, there is fall in potential. So I can take minus I R2. Now we are here. Then E2. E2 now here we are going from what? Lower to higher potential when we press the battery. So we have to take this as positive. Okay? Is it clear to you? Yeah. And then since we are going along the direction of resistance across R3, we have to take minus I R3. So this is total potential between A and B. So minus I R1, I is given 0.1 ampere. It is 10 ohm. 0.1 into 10, that is 1. So minus 1 volt. Battery, it is 10 volt. So 10 volt minus. Now here 20 into 0.1. So it is minus 2 volt plus 12 volt minus. Now 3 volt, then find out this. How much you will get? How much? Minus 4 volts. Here, what is given here? Points A and B. Okay. Suppose it is given like this, from between B and A, means we have to go from B to A. Then in that case, we are going opposite to the direction of current. So here what happens here? We have to take this as positive, this as negative, this as positive, this as positive, this as positive. Because we are going against the direction of current. For battery, here when we are going like this, for this battery we are going from higher potential to lower potential. For this battery we are going from lower potential to higher potential. So this one will take as negative, this one will take as positive. For resistance we are going opposite to the current, so we are going towards higher potential side. Here sir, suppose we go from B to A, what is equation? You will get I R1 plus E1 plus I R2 plus, sorry, minus E2 plus I R3. This is V B A and this one will be 4 volts when it is from B to A. We have to find here A and B. Is it okay? Now next one. What is the current through following circuit. So simple circuit is given. 0.5 ampere, 1 ampere, 0.2 ampere, 0.1 ampere. So what happens here? This is positive terminal of battery minus negative terminal. So current flows like this through this. And when current comes here, it has two paths to go, this one and this one. Now see here, this path, it is nothing but short across R3. Short means zero resistance. So what happens? Whatever current comes here from battery, whatever current comes here from battery, it flows like this. No current flows through 30 ohm resistance because we have short parallel to that 30 ohm resistance. So if we go along the path of current, we have only resistance 20 ohm in the path. So current is what? E upon resistance in the path. It is 10 volt divided by how much resistance? Only 20 ohm, because here we have short. So here 10 by 20, so it is 0.5 ampere. So here first one is correct, 0.5 ampere. Now compare the currents I1, I2 and I3 in the following circuit. First one, I1 equal to I2 is equal to 3. I1 equal to I2 greater than 3. I1 greater than I2 greater than 3. I1 less than I2 less than I3. So see here, here we have three resistances, they are in parallel. And here it is total incoming current, that is IT. And that IT is divided into three parts, I1 plus I2 plus I3. That is according to Kirchhoff's current law. Now what happens? So total current is divided into three parts. So what happens here? More current will flow when resistance is less. So 10 ohm resistance is less. So more current will flow through this. Then we have this resistance. So this resistance. So see here, resistance is increasing. So you will observe decreasing current. So here current is I1 will be greater than I2 will be greater than I3. So here out of this. So when we have parallel resistances, more current will flow through the resistance which has less value, means less resistance. Now what will be the potential difference across terminals A and B? Koni sangu shakta ka? Why? Because there is short. See here, this is battery. So current will flow 3 ampere. When it comes here, it has two paths to go. But this is short between A and B. So no current will flow through this. So whole current will go through this. But short has zero resistance. Resistance is zero. So resistance is zero means V is equal to I into R. Though I is 3 ampere, resistance is 0, so it is 0 volt. So if we take short, potential difference across short is 0 volt. Now next one, in series circuit, which of the following is not correct? So I can take here a simple series circuit, R1, R2, R3. And so on, Rn resistances, R1, R2, R3 up to Rn, dot dot means there is series, and here battery of here. first one, the effective resistance is R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus up to Rn. This is correct one because they are in series. Voltage across each resistance is same. So suppose this is 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 4 ohm, 5 ohm and so on. So current will flow. So here I into R1, I into R2, I into R3 and so on, I into Rn. Now since resistances are in series, current is what? E upon R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus so on Rn. So same current will flow through all resistances. So here the current through the all resistances is same. This is correct. This first one is also correct. Last one, the sum of individual voltages is equal to applied voltage. So I R1 plus I R2 plus I R3 plus so on I Rn will be equal to E. That is Kirchhoff's voltage law. But what happens here? Current is same, but resistances may be different. So what happens? Here V1 may be different than V2, may be different than V3, may be different than Vn plus, but V1 plus V2 plus V3 up to Vn will be equal to. So what happens? If we take this one, this is not correct. Voltage across each resistor is same. If resistances are same, voltage across each resistor will be same because current is same. But if resistances are different, voltages will be different. So this B is incorrect. Not correct. All other three are correct one. Now, what is the potential difference between A and B? Sangu shakta ka koni? Aman? Suraj? So what happens here, if we take current will flow like this. So when it comes here, it has two paths to go, but this is open. So what happens? Current will not flow through 4 ohm resistance, it will flow like this. Since A and B are open, this point A and point C are at the same potential. Point B and point D are at the same potential. So what happens? Whatever potential here will be equal to potential here because no current flows through 4 ohm resistance. Now here it is short. So across short potential is 0. Now same potential will come here. So it is 0 volt. So this one is correct. So thanks very much. If you have any question, you can ask. In next lecture, we'll see multiple choice questions on Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, superposition theorem, and maximum power transfer theorem. Okay.